why don't we blow it up?
I think at one point I had 14 cameras on the big set piece, just because these events are unrepeatable.
I'm running through this orrery with water just crashing down, a tidal wave coming. There's planets exploding, debris falling. I'm not even acting, it's just like go from here to here and don't get hit by anything.
We were all commenting that how lucky we are to have Angelina.
She kind of raised the bar very, very high.
Angie became Lara Croft. And so, in a way, it was like I kept forgetting that she was an actress playing the part.
Once she started things, there was really no stopping her.
There's so many things in this film. I'm really proud of it. I don't know how I'm going to adjust to normal life. When I got here, I felt like this little geek. This little, like, scrawny, you know, young actress from L.A. And then through all the training, my body had changed and my mind had changed because I had a totally different focus.
I knew that I was going to have to put Angie through some pretty rigorous training. I got her over to London and basically put her into boot camp because there were so many different disciplines that she was going to have to learn.
And I felt like I was being formed into a special agent.
We wanted to give her the opportunity to look as much of an expert as she could in all the areas that she's going to have to pursue.
Angie worked 6 days a week, doing six or seven disciplines per day to get in shape for the film. Special weight training, she had to go on special diets.
They got me on a program of vitamins and teas and protein shakes and trying to have that high protein, low carb thing. I'm like this weird experiment. They're all seeing what they can do to me.
Basically, Angelina started 3 months prior to shooting. What we had to do at first was build her physical strength up and body tone.
So I was extremely out of shape. I hadn't gone to a gym in years. I've actually changed since I got here. Much more flexible than I was, gained some weight, and put on some muscle. It's been great. They're really taking care of me.
As well as doing physical training scheme, she was then doing a fight training.
Eunice was teaching me kickboxing and really teaching me to fight. I'm trying to learn how to fight properly and learn how to really fight. And Eunice is a real fighter, so she's not just teaching me how to pretend in front of the camera. We're going through it and learning. Really trying to learn all the techniques and really know how to do it. Get this nice motion there. It's going to be jab, then go jab, and then just kick.
The sort of fighting style we've gone for is a more of a street fighter. She's not a karate expert or anything like that, but you're using a combination of things, like a full contact type karate.
I feel like I'm doing a bit of everything. I mean, we wanted to make it a real fight. I'm also learning just some good old street fighting and some knees and elbows and headbutts and, you know, a square punch in the face.
When she punches someone, they don't come back. Yoga is just relaxation, and also it's muscle tone as well. It's very good for mind and body.
I wanted her to really be as whole a human being as possible, and I think we wanted her to have that fire and that fight, but also have that really strong center and be really relaxed.
mentioning that we'd start with yoga at 6 o'clock in the morning, and then she'd come to be weapons training.
We had military weapons training, getting on your knee and knowing how to position yourself.
One target only.
And they'd set up things all around the place. Things would flip around. I'd have to duck and dive and roll. I was losing my mind.
She's a perfectionist, so she wanted to look as good as she could possibly look. There's nothing worse than to see an actor that insists he knows how to use a weapon. Everybody watches it and knows anything about a weapon. He goes, oh my God, look at it, he held a gun back.
Whichever target you come across first, treat that as a maximum threat.
Within the weapons training, she was taught by an SAS instructor. SAS is the English Special Forces.
Take out him, go for him, stoppage.
He first just taught her basically how to fire a gun.
Short bursts.
We had to bear in mind that Angelina was left-handed. We had to have a specially made gun that would fire and she could reload properly with her left hand.
Turn to your left.
I had to learn some things that she does that now I can do them. Probably unless you practice it, nobody can do those. They're her thing.
I walk in, and here I see my daughter standing on a column that's been broken down. Take her guns out and flip them in the air. And throws them into the holster.
Whoa! Doesn't anybody realize how unbelievable this is?
To sort of understand her dedication and her ability would be to sort of compared to an actor training to be an Olympic athlete and then being able to perform at the level of an Olympic athlete.
I wanted to be able to do as much as I could. And so I worked really hard to be able to jump in her world and her skin a bit.
She's just done so much. She did fight training, she did motorbike riding, she's done husky dog racing. She's done gymnastic training.
The other day I was trying to think about what haven't we done to her? You know, and I think the only thing we haven't done is lit her on fire.
Angelina should be the role model for action actors in that we turned her into something